Hey everyone, hope you're having a happy Sunday. I'm driving around trying not to be the fucking Grinch this year. It seems that all the Chinese factories this year decided to produce the ugliest Christmas ornaments I've ever seen in my fucking life. It doesn't matter what store you go to. They don't have like the shiny classic silver and gold stuff for the trees and the nice garland. It's all cheap Chinese powder-coated glitter shit. You go to the Dollar Tree and it's the same stuff they're selling at Walmart. The almost exact same. They probably came out of the same factory. Then you go out, and this place is weird because you go to one hollow and people are slow as hell. Nobody moves with a purpose and it's frustrating. And then you go to just over the mountain to the next one and everyone's all hyped up and up your ass, walking right behind you. Trying really hard not to be the Grinch this year, but it's not working out. Anytime I check my feed or check the news to see what's going on, it's always some stupid shit like Biden and the ATF trying to take away our rights and take away our guns while they release an arms dealer. You know, same thing when they tried it before last year to try to take our guns away and they armed the Taliban. Sorry for the shaky camera. These roads are unpredictable out here. But I was watching this interview with, what's that dude's name, Victor Belfort, the Belfort, that Russian arms dealer. And just look up interview and type his name in on YouTube. You'll find an interesting interview. And he's talking about people he went to prison with from the rural areas of America. And this dude has more respect for our country than Brittany Griner does. As bad as that is, maybe, just maybe, we should keep them over here. We might need somebody like that in the near future. The government and the ATF and everyone keeps trying to disarm us and take our guns like they're doing to Canada right now. We might need people like the Merchant of Death in our country helping us out. That's a thought. He seems to respect our country more than that woman, for lack of a better term, that they released while they let the Marine rot in prison over there. A guy who probably didn't commit a crime, for somebody who knowingly brought drugs into the country and is completely worthless, can't even sell out a basketball stadium, has to be subsidized by the government and the NBA, versus somebody who spent their life putting their ass on the line for this country. That's pretty piss poor. To be honest, I'd rather have the arms dealer than her. Because we're going to need people like that in the future, the way things are going. But his interview was very interesting because he said he spent time in prison with rural Americans. And rural Americans, from what he was saying, are sick of the bullshit going on in the government. They're sick of the bullshit going on in the cities. You know, they love their country. They love their traditional values. And he's talking about Christianity going away. He's talking about American traditional values going away. He's talking about how this country used to stand for something and now it's being destroyed. It's a very interesting interview from an outsider's perspective that spent time in our prisons. And it's fairly obvious at this point to everyone, including him, that this country was great, that there still are great people in this country trying to hold up our traditional values, even if it wasn't a prison system, of all places. But I thought I'd drop that. When I get home, I might post the link or pin it in the comments for you guys. Right now, I'm driving around trying to find a lumber place that's open so I can grab some wood and make a tree box for the tree. And like I said earlier, just trying not to be the Grinch this year, but all of the forces of wokeism are making it impossible. Hope you guys are having a good one. I'm out.